Hello everyone, my name is Andrew Randa, football journalist from Nigeria, and I'm here in Russia covering the Super Eagles at Russia 2018. Unfortunately, like a whole lot of you know, Nigeria lost the first game 2-0 to Croatia. It was a terrible performance by the Super Eagles. I thought they should have done better. They had, you know, fantastic preparation. Their monies were paid up front. We all know how monies work in Nigeria, so it was a good thing that, you know, everything was paid up front and they were short of their allowance. So we had no issues like that, like what happened in 2014 in Brazil, where the Nigerian team and the Ghanaian team had money issues. But this time around, everything was set for them to go out there and do the business. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. And, you know, everybody's disappointed. I am really, really disappointed. A lot of the players in the team who are senior members didn't, you know, stand up to be counted at all. You would have expected that the leader in the team would have been able to galvanize the troops and, you know, make things happen. But after the first 15 minutes, it just went downhill for Nigeria. John Mikel Obi, our skipper, didn't do well. Victor Moses, one of the leaders, didn't do well. And, you know, generally the team was poor, to be honest. I think the whole 19 minutes, we had just a shot on target and then maybe two or three off target. Odion Ighalo's header and Leon Balogun's header that went wide. So, you know, it's really, really tough at this particular moment for Nigeria. And this is the thing. We really, really need to get the maximum points against Iceland in our next game in Volgograd. We're in St. Petersburg right now, getting ready to move to Volgograd. It's going to be very, very difficult. Iceland played out a 1-1 draw with Argentina. They were really compact. They were closing down the Argentines. You know, irrespective of the fact that Messi missed a penalty kick, but I think it was a draw, you know, they really, really fought for. So they've shown they are going to be fighters. They won't just lay down and allow Nigeria to just walk over them. They're going to put up a very big fight. But at this point, Nigeria is bottom of the group. We need to get cracking. We need to get going. We need to get the points on board. If we harbor any hopes of moving to the next round, it's going to be difficult, but look, the die is cast right now. Nigeria has no other option but to go all out against Argentina. It's going to be really, really, really hard. Again, from an African perspective, it's not been a good World Cup. Tunisia yet to play as I record this. Nigeria lost, Morocco lost, Egypt lost, so it's just not too good for us at this moment. We've got Senegal and Tunisia left, and I hope they can do us proud. I hope they can get boards on point for Africa. I was very expectant against Morocco, but they didn't do pretty well against Iran. You would have thought with the stars they had, Iran should have been a cakewalk. But again, this is the World Cup. It's the biggest football tournament in the world. And surprises have been popping up here and there. But it's been really, really tough for Africa at this World Cup. And, you know, the second round of games will really tell us if we're actually prepared. But I don't want to read too much meaning into the losses so far. But I think that, you know, come the second round, African teams need to really, really step up. It would be really terrible if two or three or even four or five go out in the group stage. It would be really, really bad, you know. Again, the Nigerian team right now is a good team, but you can't compare with the teams of 1994 or 1998. Those teams had the likes of JJ Okocha, Kanu Wanko, Finidi George, Daniel Amokachi, Emmanuel Amunike, the late Stephen Keshi, the coach who took us to the 2014 World Cup, a whole lot of stars in that team, guys that were at their prime and doing really good. And if you remember, just after USA 94, we won the Olympic gold in 1996. So there was a generation that was coming through up to 1998 that we made the second round. And if not for a few things here and there, we probably have made the quarterfinals or even the semifinals in both at USA 94 and at France 98. So for me personally, I do not think there's any comparison between both teams. I think the 94 and 98 squad was much, much better. I think the 2010 squad and the 2018 squad are probably on the same level, but it's not been really, really good for you know, Nigeria so far in the coming years. There are a few guys that are coming through: Kelechi Iheanacho, Alex Iwobi, Moses Simon. They're the new generation that I think will take us through. But right now, I think the previous Nigerian teams at the World Cup, especially at the 1994 World Cup and the 1998 World Cup, were much, much better than this squad. Finally, I think General Raw needs to tweak his team a bit. We played the 3-5-2 in the second half against England, and it really showed that the boys adapted to it. And I think that that's what he needs to go up with. Again, we need to also get the balls to the wings and cross. I think Nigeria over the years, from 1980 when we won the Nations Cup, we've always been a team that plays from the wing. Even the USA 94 World Cup, most of our goals, 75% of our goals were from the wing. So we need to get back to the wings, get fast strikers that can get the ball into the box. And I think someone like Simeon Nwankwo, who is about 6 foot five, 6 foot six, should start the game, you know, because Iceland are big, they're strong, and they're quite physical. So we need our players that can be as technical as possible and also, you know, bring in their physicality and their frame into the game. And then I also expect Tyrone Boyhi to start. Show Abdullah did a pretty well at right back, but he wasn't as mobile as Tyrone. So I think Tyrone should start. I think he's a better crosser of the ball. I think he's more offensive than Shehu. And so I think Ro really needs to tweak the team. It didn't work against Croatia. I'm hoping when they get back to the training ground, they'll be able to try something else. They've got 5 days to perfect their plans for Iceland. And I hope that at the end of the day, they'll be able to do Nigeria proud.